Hey everyone, welcome back to another Very Geek Reaction. Today we're going to be reacting to the next episode of Vinland Saga. This is Vinland Saga episode 13, yep, Child of a Hero. So I'm assuming this is about Thorfinn, finally. Well, not finally. It feels like this has been Askeladd's story most of the time. Which some of you do agree, it kind of does. And some of you did say that season 1 would probably be more about Askeladd, as Thorfinn's more just here for now. But yeah, so this seems like it's going to be a long episode. Hopefully it sounds intense. Usually when it's a title based on the main character. Yeah. So, well, that being said, let's just jump into the reaction. Well, it would help if there was sound, right? Already intense. There's no intro. Pause. Wait. I'm confused. That sounds like Thorfinn. Oh, we're just this. Everything's new. Okay. Okay, new opening. Okay, I'm digging it. Ooh, canoe looks epic in that one. Ooh, the wolf shot. Oh. Okay. Yo, okay, that was beastly. Ooh, canoe looks confident. Okay, thoughts on the intro? I dig it. I think it'll grow on me. I like the rock, like the not the rock, but like the beat. I love the visuals in it too. I think it'll grow on me. I wasn't expecting a new intro. It definitely feels like we're in the second half, obviously, of Vinland Saga, where things are gonna propel forward. Where I think we're finally not leaving, but we're going into more Thorfinn focused stuff. Even though it's been all about like Askeladd and Thorfinn. Oh, okay. Good to know he actually does care about his son. And I just wanted to mention, I know I'm a nerd for this. No, you're a nerd. I recognize it sounds like the voice of Hashirama Senju from, obviously, Naruto. So it's funny, I hear Hashirama and then I ask a lot of his moderate voice actor. I know, whatever. I'm an idiot. Stop it. Horses will always forever have a negative track record in seinen manga. I love that. Like, obviously it's on Japanese for the audience, but like the only one that understands them is Askeladd. So for them, they're speaking a whole bunch of gibberish. They have no idea how intense what they're talking about. I mean, that is true. He still loves his son. These days, a sheep must wear wolf's skin. I love that saying. Super effeminate. Super. Has no idea what to say. Are they inferring? I mean, I don't think they're inferring that his entire like family just killed each other in front of him. But man, okay, so I guess it was just plain and simple a rough childhood, and he just survived through all of that. Okay, and he's trying to like piece it together, but he can't get over that trauma with this guy just protecting him the whole time. I cannot read Askeladd at all. He's interesting. I don't know what's on his mind. He has to make the chick leave the nest. Okay. I was really waiting just most of the time to just say like what I was thinking, but it is fascinating how that Canute doesn't want to like say anything. Obviously, it's because there's some trauma there. And ironically, Ragnar keeps reiterating. He keeps all the time for the past episodes that no one should control how he acts. No one should like dictate how he, you know, whatever. Through him retroactively protecting him retroactively, he is ended up controlling him in a way that like now Canute is dependent on him and feels like the only way he can talk is through Ragnar. So very ironic to me, the way Ragnar speaks to everyone else but doesn't look in the mirror. But I can understand where Ragnar is coming from. Don't get it twisted. Secret. Interesting. This dude looks like Erwin and Armin put together. Definitely weird how, like, they were... I mean, I know they were offering to just talk, but it's just funny how we went from, like, a very tense situation to now both of them on top of a cliff or a hill, and they're just both talking, like kind of chill. So, I just think it's funny. Especially after threatening to take the prince as a shield. He is a little upset for not knowing everything. Oh, whoa. Inherited the blood of the great leaders of the Rome. Whoa. That makes sense. Like, aesthetically, his armor. Like, he's the only one with that type of armor. Like, you know the type of armor I'm thinking about. Where, like, it's very, like... masculine. Interesting. Yeah, this is Askeladd season. Oh, I dropped that. Wow. Okay. I thought this episode was about Thorfinn. I was completely wrong. Okay, interesting. Okay. Oh, shit. Wow. Okay, big IQ plays by Askeladd. Wow, okay, he's looking like years into the future. Wow, okay. This episode is twisted real quick. Damn. Oh my god, there's so much character development like in one exposition moment. So we know he's mixed now. We know what he wants to do. Again, I still don't even believe him, to be honest, because of how like cunning he is. I don't believe 100% that that's what he wants to do. That he hates the Danes. Interesting. I don't think he does. Or if he does, he does. I don't know. I can't get a read on him. Never have. Okay. Thorfinn is rude. He called him Conan. And he called Askeladd Baldy. What? From that angle, I thought Askeladd was like 10 feet tall. Fascinating how much crap they talk while they're not fighting. Okay. Oh, guy, you cautious, but you slipped up and spoke. Oh, freaking Thorfinn broke through the barrier. Awesome. I don't know why I paused. Because I usually talk only like over the video if it's playing with nothing really is happening. Like, okay, so he signed the treaty. Oh, so they're just montaging the journey. Got it. It was interesting hearing Canute talk for the first time, standing up for himself. I'll save what I think about this whole isn't wrong thing till the end, which, let me check. Oh, we're close, okay. Okay. Also, this is the outro, the new one. Is that Canute or like a Valkyrie? Very Attack on Titan-y, the like visuals. Obviously, same studio. Wow. Okay. Whoa. Okay, I did the vocals. Nice. Nice. Okay, I dig it. My camera's about to cut off, so. Valhalla, yeah. Okay, so that's that. So now, quickly, my thoughts. I feel like it's leading into the finale of like everyone saying that Askeladd isn't wrong, specifically Askeladd's partner. I feel like that's gonna end badly. That's just a feeling I got. But overall, really good episode. We got some dilemma for Canute, Askeladd, and Thorfinn a little bit because he's a little bit more casual around Canute. But yeah. Well, that being said, hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure you guys follow me on my Twitter. Make sure you guys do like, comment, subscribe, and share the video if you enjoyed. And I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye, guys.